Does that answer your question? Sincerely yours, The Breakfast Club. Hey people, my name's Jim and you have landed on Planet Rewind, and in this video I'm going to be doing a review on an 80s classic, The Breakfast Club, which I recently rewatched and I was blown away. I love this movie, I always have, but this watch has just blown me away even more. I genuinely think this probably is one of my favourite films of all time. It's an unbelievable film and it's possibly the greatest teen film ever written. The Breakfast Club obviously tells the story of five kids who spend a Saturday in detention because they've each done something bad, and they're all lumped together. They're all from different social circles, they don't know each other, but they get to know each other. And it's just this coming of age experience for all of them. The film of course stars Judd Nelson as John Bender, who is the cocky, arrogant, angry young man, kind of criminal tendencies. Molly Ringwald is Claire Standish, the kind of pretty princess type girl. Emilio Estevez is Andrew Clark, who is a wrestler, who's like the sporty one. Anthony Michael Hall is Brian Johnson, who is the smart geeky guy. And Ali Sheedy plays Allison, who is the strange kind of basket case they label her in the film. Straight from the beginning, that song by The Simple Minds, Don't You Forget About Me, is perfection for this film. I think it's one of the greatest songs of all time, but it's perfect for this film. It's just full of so much joy, so much elation, but it channels all the feelings, all the nostalgic, melancholy feelings of this film. It's a touching film and immediately gets you into that mood of, yes, I'm watching The Breakfast Club. Yes. I don't know if there's ever been a song that is so synonymous with a movie as Simple Minds, Don't Forget About Me. Just, it's a wonderful song. It fills me with joy and I just know what's to come. It's such a great, you know, familiar feeling when you start watching this movie. Love's strange, surreal and the dark. Think of the tender things that we were working on. Slow change may pull us apart. When the light gets in your heart, baby, don't you forget about me. Don't you forget about me. I have heard Quentin Tarantino label some movies as hangout movies, where you go back to them every few years and you just love seeing the characters again. It's like old friends. And I think Breakfast Club is one of the prime examples of that. I just love these characters. I think John Hughes is an absolute genius when it comes to writing teenage characters. I don't know how he done it. I don't know how he bloody done it, but John Hughes channeled the teenage spirit. He understood. It seems like he was always eternally in that mindset, you know, relating. You know, the writing is so meticulous, but so relatable and so earnest and deep. And, you know, it's a fun movie. It's a happy movie, but there's depth to this. There is depth to this. This would not get made today. John Hughes is discussing the human condition at the teenage age in this film. There is real characters in this. It could easily not have been like this. It could have easily just been, let's just make them have fun, let's just have a screwball movie. But this is grounded. This is real characters, real people with real life struggles. And there must have been so many, like thousands of teenagers who went to see this in the 80s and just thought, there's me. And just completely found themselves through this movie. Breakfast Club is a film all about grey areas, about seeing what's beyond the surface. And I love that. It's a film that accepts that stereotypes pretty much are never accurate. And you know, we go through our lives just going, oh well, I wouldn't get on with him and I wouldn't get on with her, and I know what he's like, I know what she's like. And it's something I'm trying to get away from in my life, but this film just crystallises it. You know, you put these people together and you realise they're more similar than they thought, but you realise they're also nothing like you thought about them. It's like nothing is black and white, there are always grey areas. You think someone's life is a certain way, but it's actually not. Every single character in this has its own way of struggling through life. So it's just so applicable to daily life when you look at someone and you're just like, well, they don't have my struggles. They have different struggles. Everyone has struggles, but they have different ones. And this film is about appreciating what other people are going through and getting to know other people outside of your comfort zone and realizing that we're all the same, essentially. You know, who even bad people can do good things. For example, Bender in this film is quite a bad guy, but he has a good side to him. He's not entirely evil. Now, a lot of people might see a character like John Bender and go, oh, he's just evil. He's just an evil kid, you know. But if you actually get to know the guy, you'll know why he does things. You'll know why he's been driven to this life and why he's actually someone who wants to go down a different path, a good path. Why he has some good tendencies. It's just a film about opening yourself up to other people's struggles and other people's life stories. And I love that about it. It's so earnest. It is so well done. It's so organic. And it makes it seem like it's going to show you stereotypes. I mean, literally the characters in the film all have their kind of name, stereotypical name, but then normally the film's like, no, they're not stereotypes at all. I'm getting rid of stereotypes. So I love that. I love how the film sets it up. You're just going to see these stereotypical people hanging out together, but by the end of the film, there's no stereotypes. I love the slow build of the friendship in this between the Breakfast Club. It's so believable, the way that John Hughes eases us into these characters getting to know each other. It's so organic, it's so well paced. You know, he does so well to lead us through this Saturday, and you never at one point think, well, he wouldn't do that and she wouldn't do that, they wouldn't be getting closer. But he's just done so well, masterfully, with the dialogue and the set pieces, and just the way these characters get gradually closer. It's anything but unbelievable. And it's also a film not only about breaking stereotypes, but about the pressures of upholding an identity, about the pressures of buying into your own stereotype and how hard that can be, and trying to live up to what your parents thrust on you, or what society thrust on you, or what your friends thrust on you. And that the fact that we all do it, like the nerdy people do it, the popular people do it, it's just all in their own way. And it's fascinating how John Hughes explores that through some of the most genuine teenage dialogue I've ever heard. The dialogue in this film is absolutely stunning. It is stunning. There are so many scenes which gradually just go under the surface, and just we get inside these characters. We feel like we know these characters. These characters become our friends just as much as they're becoming friends on screen. There's so many great moments, like when John Bender starts off by doing a comical impression of Brian's, the nerdy guy's, home life, but then he gradually eases it into his home life, and it gets dark. It gets disturbing. It's a fantastic scene which lots of people know the movie for.
Son. Yeah, Dad. How's your day, pal? Great, Dad. How's yours? Super. Say, son, how'd you like to go fishing this weekend? Great, Dad. But I've got homework to do. That's all right, son. You can do it on the boat. Gee. Dear. Isn't our son swell? Yes, dear. Isn't life swell? Oh. Oh.
All right. What about your family?
Oh, mine?
Yeah.
It's real easy. Stupid, worthless, no good, goddamn freeloading son of a bitch, retarded, big mouth, know-it-all asshole jerk. You forgot ugly, lazy, and disrespectful. Shut up, bitch! Go fix me turkey pot pie. What about you, Dad? Fuck you. No, Dad. What about you? Fuck you! No, Dad! What about you? Fuck you!
I love Andrew's conversation with Allison, where she told him to go away, but he gets her to open up to him that life at home is bad. And the facial expressions, the music, the subtlety, the relatability, the characters unlocking the key to each other's heart, you know, becoming friends. John Hughes does it so well. You know, writer and director John Hughes, I don't know what he was doing, but he just tuned in to genuine teenage relationships and emotions and relatability. You could put that guy in the room with teenagers And he wouldn't seem like the creepy old guy. He just got it. He just got it. And he just never grew up, I guess. He kept his kind of heart and soul. And that's a line in the film. When you grow up, you lose your soul. But John Hughes obviously never did.
Go away.
Where do you want me to go?
Go away. You have problems.
Oh, I have problems.
You do everything everybody ever tells you to do. That is a problem.
Okay, fine. But I didn't dump my purse out on the couch and invite people into my problems. Did I? So what's wrong? What is it? What do they do to you?
They ignore me.
Yeah.
The only thing I don't understand about the film and the way the characters talk, but it's not... The Breakfast Club isn't the only film that's guilty of it. Many American films do this, where the characters pressure each other into admitting whether they're a virgin or not. It just blows my mind how there's so many, like, films that... young people would watch. Even Disney films do this, Hocus Pocus for example, where the character's like 15, 16, and like there's a real pressure to not be a virgin. It's like you find out at one point that Brian admits, yeah, I'm a virgin, and I'm sitting there watching, yeah, I fucking hope so, Brian. The dialogue pieces back and forth are just unbelievable, and that scene where they talk about will they still be friends after this day is stunning. It is stunning. All five performances are electric. All five performances pull at your heartstrings and break your heart and then warm your heart. Every emotion in that scene, wonderfully played. And I love how this film is about how life can change in one day if you just open to a new experience or if you're just open to a new person. It's about how much can change in such a short space of time. These characters come out of that Saturday completely different, with a completely new outlook on the world and some new friends. And I love that. It just made me feel so happy every time I watch it. Such a happy film. And I know people like to watch this and imagine what it's like to be young again. I don't watch it and want to be young again. I watch it and I feel optimistic. I watch it and I want to see what's in my future, because I don't feel like this film is specifically can only be experienced by young people. Obviously they're the main ones that are going to relate to it, but I feel like it is about opening up to life, opening up to those people you cut off, opening up to new experiences, and how if you feel like you've been in a rut, your life can change in such a short space of time. And The Breakfast Club resonates with me. I believe it. I believe this film is possible. I genuinely do. Alison says in the film, when you grow up your heart dies. Well, not mine. Not just yet, and I hope you guys feel the same. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of The Breakfast Club. I think it's a masterpiece. I think it's a teen movie masterpiece, and it's in some of my favourite films of all time. Let me know. Let me know who your favourite character is in the film, your favourite quote. There's so many quotes. Let me know all that good stuff. Let's discuss The Breakfast Club in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this nostalgic movie talk, please subscribe to Planet Rewind, and we can carry on reminiscing. And join me on Friday, where I'm going to be ranking the Terminator movies. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you next time.